us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord.
We pray for all the angels.
Word from the Lord.
We glory.
Just one word from the Lord.
Because Lord, you always word it to
the devil.
Comfort and care that we need for such a time as this. We ask you, Lord, to speak through your word, for your people need to hear a word from you.
Yes, Lord.
We commit ourselves over to you.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Thank you,
Jesus. And praise
the
Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. This morning in your handouts, it's program, it says that there should be a message entitled The Hand of God from 1 Peter 5 through 6. God has led me to a different text. We'll come back to this series in humility, because we've been studying humility this whole month. God has led me this morning in a different direction. So this morning we're going to share a message from Hebrews chapter 12. Verses 12 through 13, and we're going to be reading from the NLT, a message entitled Get a Grip, or How to Get a Grip on Life.
All right.
Say to your neighbor,
neighbor,
oh neighbor, get a grip.
Get a grip.
Say to your neighbor on your other side, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Get a grip.
Get a grip.
We're going to learn how to get a grip. Would you please stand in reverence to the word of God? Stand symbolically saying that I will stand on the word of God for such a time as this. Let's read this together on three. One, two, three.
So take a grip with your hands and strengthen your weak knees. Mark out a straight path for your feet so that those who are weak and lame will not fall but become strong.
Amen. You may be seated in the household of the Lord. This morning again, how to get a grip on life. We're going to study how to get a grip on life. Study what we need to do with our fists or our hands. I encourage you this morning to faint not with weak knees. I encourage you this morning to mark out a straight path for your feet, to go over it, under it, around it. And we want to encourage those who may be feeble or weak this morning. We want Christians to know that Christians should get a grip in the stressful times.
Amen.
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 Amen. I had a little talk with God yesterday about the tragedy that happened on the freeway. I had a little talk with God because I was so sad, particularly because those who died were so young.
Amen.
Yvonne was so young. Juju was so young. I had a little talk with God yesterday trying to make sense of these tragic events. God laid it upon my heart as I had a little talk with God.
Amen.
That it's upon it that all of us to die.
Amen.
Sometimes we forget that everyone will go the way of the grave.
Mm.
And I was so sad because they were so young, and God brought back to my memory what Dr. Tony Evans said about death and about age. That we really don't know the age of a person by their birth date. We should determine the age of a person only by their death date.
Amen.
Because if I'm 41 and I'm going to die at 42, then I'm old. Because there's an appointment that I will have to keep that I don't have to worry about being on time.
All right.
There's an appointment that I have to keep that I don't have to worry about trying to be 15 minutes early. And that's an appointment with death. So I don't know how old I am. And the only way you can determine that is by my death date. So God was telling me that they were not young. They lived the life that he preordained them to live. They were as old as God wanted them to be. So in my little talk with God, God told me to get a grip. God told me to get a grip. I don't know if this message is just for me or if it's for you. But somebody here today, God is trying to tell you to get a grip.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes. Say to your neighbor.
Neighbor.
Get a grip.
Get a grip.
For this text was written and it says, so take a new grip with your tired hands.
Yes.
Take a new grip with your tired hands. In the text this morning, it was written to people who were already tired. It was written to people that were already going through. It was written to a people like some of us here today who have been through it the last month, who have been through it the last 6 months, who have been through it the last year, the last 2 years. Some of us have seen death too much and too often, and some of us are weak. We have weak and tired hands, and God is telling us to do with our fists. Oh, to take a new grip with your tired hands.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, I was remembered and reminded of how when I was in high school, we would have field days, and in those field days, we would, as a class, have to come up against another class in what they call the tug of war. And then one class would be pulling, and it would look like that class would have the victory, when all of a sudden, some of those people who were tired of pulling on the rope, they would let loose, and they would get a new grip. And when they got a new grip, they would get new strength, new energy, and it seems like that they were about to lose, but because they didn't give up, because they didn't give in, oh, they were able to get a grip with their tired hands. God is saying to somebody here this morning, get a new grip with your tired hands, for your life is not over. Get a new grip with your tired hands.
On the sea, but what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.